But when you are playing, do you completely play just what's in your head, or do you use kind of concepts, tonality concepts?
I see what you're saying. Well, for me, I'm going to use an analogy that I heard from Gary Burton, which is a great one, which is, you just ask me a question. You've been speaking English a long time, you know how to speak English. Somewhere in your mind, you were putting together verbs and adjectives and pronouns, and you were doing all the grammar that was correct for you to get the meaning across. Improvisation is exactly the same. There's a language that's, you know, has grammar. And, you know, this is a language I've been dealing with for 20 years now. And I mean, in terms of sitting down, and if you were to hand me, you know, 50 unrelated chords, I could solo through them, and I would, all those connections would be made, and it, you know, I would play 90% right notes, you know, or correct things. But I would also be hearing it, because I would be having ideas, and they all kind of go together, which to me just comes from experience and just doing it a lot. For me, while I'm playing, I'm not thinking about tonalities or chords or this or that, but it's an element in what I'm doing. Just like while I'm speaking to you now, in the front of my mind, I'm not thinking about verbs and adjectives and nouns. I'm just talking, because I can do it. Yeah. And it's the same with improvisation. But learning the grammar of improvisation is a fairly difficult job. You know, for me, to really understand the vocabulary of improvisation as implied by Charlie Parker and John Coltrane is, you know, it's a good 6 or 7 year study, you know, minimum, to really get it so that you're fluent in that vocabulary. And to me, this is essential. You know, you have to have a strong sense of the bebop language to play any kind of jazz. And when I hear guys, whether they're free guys or fusion guys or new age guys or whatever you call it, that don't have the bebop language down, I always get bored. Because to me, that's the foundation that everything else is built on. And in this sense, I'm very conservative. I don't have too much tolerance for music that doesn't have that language as a part of it. So, you know, I guess the answer to your question is simple, which is, yes, I do think in terms of notes and chords and melodies, but it's, you know, on a subconscious level, and I'm basically, when I'm playing, I'm just playing what I hear, but all those other elements are in there.
Yes, and is this already the 20 years, or because I noticed that in the people are different. There are people who need who feel the need to constantly know what they are doing. Mm. Did you have the same process in yourself in
sure.
the beginning, and then later on it's getting fluid?
Yeah, you know, it's difficult. It's hard, and especially at the beginning, you know, to play on, you know, a tune where there's chords going by like this. You know, it's not something that too many people instantly can do. I mean, you know, you do have to take the time to learn it. And of course, you know, when you're starting, it's like kind of overwhelming. But, you know, it's a matter of time and just doing it, and also being around people who can do it, I think is maybe the best thing. In my case, I was very lucky because I grew up around Kansas City in Missouri, where there was a very active jazz scene. And my education wasn't sitting in a room with a book. It was being with guys going 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then doing the best I could, you know. And that was a great situation for me to be in because it was for real. It wasn't theoretical. It was like, you know, do it, you know. And, you know, I sounded very bad. I mean, I was only 15 or 16 years old at the time. In the first couple years, you know, I sounded terrible. But gradually, you know, I mean, and I'm still working to try and get better, but I mean, you know, as you do it more, you get more insight and wisdom about what it is that you're trying to do. And, you know, it's a difficult process, but I do feel like it's it's something that can be quantified. I mean, it's something that you can learn on a sort of, like you're talking about, on an intellectual level, at least just to get the grammar of it down. I mean, there's a whole other point after what we're talking about, which is actually the most important part, which is the sort of actual creativity. I mean, what you finally do play. But I mean, we're sort of talking on a more basic level, just the nuts and bolts of it. And I would say, yeah, you have to understand it on an intellectual level first. I mean, on a, you know, like you were talking about having it in your mind what you're doing all the time. I think that's step one, you know. But there's, you know, a few other steps after that. Eventually, you want to get it to where you're not thinking about it.
People like Chet Baker, he didn't know the changes theoretically, so it's possible to just hear it and play it.
Yes, there's a number of examples of that. Freddie Hubbard's a good example of that too. Ornette Coleman is a great example of that. But all of these people that I've known, that I've hung out with, you know, they say, I don't know changes, but they do.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I mean, they don't call it. I mean,
even their own system.
Yeah, even for me, because of where I grew up, and the people that I played with, they didn't talk about a diminished scale, but they played it. And they didn't talk about the harmonic minor to this and that, but they played it. And for me, when I joined Gary Burton, his group, he's maybe the best guy I've seen in terms of being able to clearly describe harmony and really say, okay, when you see this and you do that, you do this because of that, you know. I mean, he can really explain it. And in about 6 months, he took me aside and said, look, you know, when you see this and you're doing that, what you're really doing is, you know, mixolydian to this, to that. And then I learned it. But before I had somebody like him to sit down next to me, I was doing all those things. I just didn't have the official name for it. So, you know, Chet Baker, you know, had an amazing melodic sense. And Freddie Hubbard, to me, is really amazing because he plays really complex, interesting, right kind of harmonic stuff without, as far as I know, really analyzing it in terms of what, you know, we would all agree on in terms of chord scales and stuff.